fascinating yesterday, Dennis. We spent the afternoon in a pedestrian mall downtown, the Cai, Florida. The offices of La Nation, one of the country's largest newspapers, are located there. And every day at noon, people gather to look at the headlines, read the latest bit of information that's coming out about the situation on the Malvinas. What we found were people who are passionately involved in this discussion. They stand there. The arguments are heated. The discussions are intense. What they are talking about is the Argentinian commitment, the need to do this. They must. They feel that they are going to fight this war, that they are going to win this war. There's no talk almost anymore of whether or not there will be a fight, only when. Well, the reports late last night here were that, of course, the talks were on the verge of breaking down. In fact, that there were just informal talks there. And the foreign minister, Costa Mendes, held a late-night press conference last night to again say that Argentina was looking for a peaceful settlement, but that the British, quote, intransigence was going to prevent that. Again this morning, we have an interesting bit of news. These bits of information from the military junta are released in press releases throughout the night and picked up. They were saying last night and reported again this morning that a call by the defense minister here in Argentina to the United States for what they call an effective contribution to the peace process. This is a bit of a change from what we can gather in Argentine strategy. Of course, the feelings against the United States are running very high in this country. But what it seems to come down to is President Galtieri, if he is going to agree to a withdrawal at all, will need total American backing, the endorsement of President Reagan on the question of sovereignty, in the sense that sovereignty will be guaranteed.